Ah, yes, Rio. Welcome to Olympic Channel's latest Throwback Thursday. It is Rio 2016 and Carioca Arena. This drive down memory lane features the USA and Serbia. It's a Group A pool stage battle as the U.S. looks to extend its Olympic Games basketball winning streak to 21 in a row. Now, we know Serbia's talented, but they had lost two of their three games in Group A coming into this immense matchup with the two-time defending gold medalist who had just escaped Australia in a game that was much closer than expected. Here you see the Group A standings. There's the Australians, U.S. still unbeaten, of course. They would meet France to close that group play in a couple of days' time. So, perhaps sensing the Americans' vulnerability, Serbia was very excited. 9 of the 12 Serbians played together, taking the silver medal at the 2014 FIBA World Cup. Sasha Djordjevic coached them in 2014 as well, and you know, he played on Yugoslavia's Olympic silver medal winning team in Atlanta 1996. Several of the USA's biggest stars like LeBron James, Steph Curry, Kawhi Leonard, Russell Westbrook, and James Harden didn't come to Rio for various reasons. Only Kevin Durant and Carmelo Anthony played on the Golden Team in London 2012. Still, the red, white, and blue was expected and expecting to win gold again. It was Coach K's final ride down the Golden Brick Road. So it was a rematch from the 2014 FIBA World Cup Championship game. Before they battled, the teams, of course, exchanged gifts in keeping with Olympic custom. The All-NBA USA team featured 10 first-time Olympians. Serbia only had one NBA player, Nikola Jokic of the Denver Nuggets, an all-rookie NBA, all-rookie first team in his first season. He would be a tough cover for the U.S. in this one. Now, both teams, you know, they're going to be nervous and a bit sloppy at the start. Serbia's nightmare beginning would include turnovers and many missed shots, allowing the USA to get out and run right away. And then you never want to foul somebody at the three-point line. Kevin Durant lets it go and draws the three free throws, which he would make. Coach K, you know, they're going to come out in a dogged man-to-man defense. And there's an unforced error, part of the problems. Markovic essentially just dribbles off his leg out of bounds. Early turnover. Of course, Durant, when he has the ball, draws two or three people. Nice kick to the corner. Paul George. And just like that, 45 seconds into the game, and it's 6-0. But the nightmare start was just beginning for a Serbian team that certainly sensed the opportunity with the USA again showing the vulnerability against Australia. But if they wanted to put the USA back on their heels, it wasn't happening right away. And there's another turnover, and here comes the US, always wanting to push the pace in the open floor. They certainly believed that their athleticism and basketball IQ, they wanted to get Serbia backpedaling and defending in the open court. Durant, as he so often does, plays the point forward spot. Kick to the corner, Kyrie Irving over to Carmelo Anthony, never shy to let it fly. And here comes Serbia. And a foul as Melo gets a good piece of Miroslav Radulica. He missed his free throws. And another opportunity. Radulica off, and here we go. DeMarcus Cousins, they call him Boogie Cousins. And he's certainly dancing on the go. And while the USA is celebrating, not so much the case. Sasha Djordjevic, not at all happy. And he'd already let the referees hear about it. I don't speak Serbian, but I'm pretty sure the message was sent and received. An intense man, a star point guard in the 90s and 2000s in Europe. And he'd already picked up the tee, but you know, Sasha, as any kind of coach, he's gonna try to get in a few last words while he has the referee's attention. Sometimes you gotta get a tee in a game, maybe to wake your team up or to get the referee's attention. Anyway, here we go. 9-0, just 3 minutes in. Finally, Nikola Jokic down the lane. Nice assist, one of six assists from his teammate. Teodosic. Here we go again, 9-2 now. Look at Cousins, the deflection and the assist to George. Sweet move along the baseline, but even when they score, it's after the shot clock goes off. So 11-2, and believe it or not, it's only going to get worse. Teodosic right now playing with the LA Clippers. That ball around and out. Georgievic still trying to find an answer on the court. And it's time for Kyrie Irving to get busy. Now DeMarcus Cousins down low, and somehow that bounces around and goes. Cousins, 5 points in the game. 3 rebounds, 5 assists for the big man. How about that for the ball game? Nice entry pass, another turnover. But it was avoided as Cousins had his big foot in the way. And there, finally, Miloš Teodosic knocks down the three, and there is some hope for Serbia. But look at the ball movement down in the corner. The Warriors, Klay Thompson, that's easy money for him. Another wide open look and an opportunity to go back to back, not there. DeAndre Jordan gives it up to Klay Thompson. Now watch these two work together. Little screen, a little penetration, a little give and go, little drive and go get it. And DeAndre Jordan finishes. Two-time NBA rebounding leader. Certainly knows how to finish above the rim. So at this point, 19-5, and maybe fans are thinking this is going to be a 30-point blowout. And again, another strip. And that is Jordan with the strip and assist down to Jimmy Butler. It's easy so far. 5 points in the game, and Serbia's played 6 minutes here. And another turnover. Here comes Jimmy Butler now. Now it's Draymond Green's chance to send Jordan in. It's not Michael. DeAndre's finishing, and that's it. Georgievic says, I've seen enough. I got to talk to my guys again. And again, a very energized, very spirited timeout. U.S. thinking, hey, we're on a roll, but not so fast. Great ball movement. Nikola Jokic to Miroslav Radulica. Here, a little give and go. Watch, it goes back to Jokic. Great look down low. Finally, an easy hoop to the men in red. And we'll go right back down a little bit later. This time, Radulica gonna do a little big man punishing of DeAndre Jordan. This is all well and good if there's no foul. And there goes Radulica and some of the other Serbian Olympic teammates. Enjoying that, Jordan not so much. You get the idea that the momentum is switching a little bit. Off the miss. Draymond Green, Kyle Lowry, Klay Thompson, corner Jimmy Butler, way too easy. There wasn't a hand anywhere near him. It's 27-9. It would be 27-15 after the first quarter. We are into the second quarter now and some hope. Look at this. This is what Serbia needs. Oh, my goodness. Nedovic with the deep three. And here they go again. Jokic down low. Great look. Nikola Jokic, you're going to see him take over in the fourth quarter. What a handful he was for the U.S. to try to contain, just like he is these days for the Denver Nuggets. Great defense. 5 second violation. Serbia back within 11. Coach K understands this game's going to tighten up. He was not expecting a blowout. Miloš Teodosic gets it going. And now Teodosic letting fly, and they're starting to feel it. Could this maybe be the day? These two teams met in the 2014 World Cup final. Wasn't very close. Now Kyrie doing some dancing. Three for you, three for me. And look at the great look from Teodosic down to Radulica. Right there, one of Miloš's six assists. And you get the sense this is a team that knows how to play basketball. Their ball movement is excellent. They just had to start hitting some shots, which now they finally have. Look at Kyrie Irving step back. That'll earn you a letter in the game of horse. Now watch, this is what I was referring to. Seven Serbians touched the ball. Good, better, best. Nikola Jokic, wide open, take that. That is basketball. And now, Carmelo Anthony's never met a three he didn't love. We go the other way. It's Jokic ahead of the field. And now there's a real sense that Serbia's right back in this. Late second quarter. Late shot clock. Look at Markovic do his work. That should be a four-pointer. My goodness. But you know, the U.S. has so much talent. Never mind that there's only two veterans from the London 2012 gold medal team. One of them is that guy, Kevin Durant. Knocks down three of his 12. Klay Thompson having a good time. The U.S. heads in only up nine, though. Remember, it was 18 late in the first quarter. Certainly the crowd at Carioca Arena hoping for just as much fun in the second half. They sense that Serbia is here to play, and what a stage it was throughout Rio 2016 for Brazil. What a show they put on. Meantime, there is the timeout. Coming out third quarter. Look at the ball movement, and Bogdanović spot up three. Remember that late in the game. I will refer back to that. Open look, and he knocked it down, and here comes Serbia. Melo almost steps out of bounds. When he sees that he doesn't, he throws up three. Now, these teams are immensely talented, and the effort is there, but there's about five turnovers in the space of about 10 seconds here. It's not done yet. Look at this, all over the place. Finally, a foul brings an end to the madness. And on the side, Kyle Lowry, Kevin Durant saying that wasn't good. That wasn't good at all. Here we go. Watch Markovic on the drive. Here he comes, coming around to nine. Pump fake and goes right by, up and over everybody. Paul George spinning around, Cousins. Eventually ends up being a turnover, and here comes Serbia. Miloš Teodosic feeling much better about things now. Coach, maybe not so much, still wants more. All the way in, what a penetration move, Bogdanović. Now, DeMarcus Cousins is good, but he's not a point guard. Second turnover in a row. And again, Serbia hands in the passing lanes and making the crowd jump for joy. Off the screen, Bogdanović. Nice pass, Jokic finishes. Oh, they're starting to get it going now. Off the out of bounds play. This is just a give me dunk for DeAndre Jordan. That is a rally killer. Kevin Durant loving that. And back to the timeout. Georgievich. Brilliant tactician, understands what he wants from his guys, understands what he can get from his guys. Now, watch Miloš Teodosic right there. Gives it, cuts away off the screen. Look at that nice movement off the ball. And it's a 5-point game. Carioca Arena loving this. Jimmy Butler penetrating, knocked around, and he'll go to the foul line. There's Teodosic letting it go. Another look at the same shot. Great little action where he went one way and the other to set up the defender coming off the screen, wide open three. Now, Jimmy Butler at the line. USA back up 67-60. Here comes Serbia, down 7, late third quarter. And DeAndre Jordan says, not here. And here comes the U.S. DeMar DeRozan, not giving it up. He wants to go to work. They isolate. And watch the good ball movement all the way in. Easy. Where's the defense? And the USA back in charge by 9. Georgievich not pleased. Another possession, another chance to cut into the 11-point lead now. There's a foul. Body to body defense, physical, both teams equal to the challenge. And look at that. DJ and Nikola Jokic laughing it up. Quarter winding down. Chance for Serbia to get it under 10. Jokic. Difficult turnover late in a quarter. Chance for the U.S. to add to the 10-point lead. Clock winding down. Jimmy Butler step back, just a little short, and that's it. After three quarters here in Group A play, the U.S. up 10, heading to the last 10 minutes. So after the awful start, Serbia is right in this, right there with the U.S., 47-45 over the last two quarters. USA winning by 2, but that first quarter set Serbia back. Starting off quarter number 4. A far cry from the energy we saw in the first 5 or 6 minutes from Serbia, where they were just overwhelmed. Now back in it, feeling confident, but they know they need a run to make a dent in this 10-point deficit. And again, Nikola Jokic having a lot of fun playing these days for the Denver Nuggets. What a team they have. And this was a sign of things to come. The step back three, he can play everywhere, anywhere on the court. Next possession. Jokic on a personal 5-0 run, and they're within six now. Georgievich says, hey, now we're playing. Kyle Lowry, good to work here with DJ. Great pass from the big man. Lowry finishes. Down the other end. On the go, off the miss. Good board work. Here comes Serbia. You see, they're hesitant to attack like the U.S. will in the open floor. They want to come down. They want to make the U.S. defend. They want to run their sets. Great look. Another one of Fedosic's six assists in the game. 8 minutes to go. It's a five-point game. Who would have thought this after watching the first 6 minutes of this one? And Serbia could do almost nothing right. Well, they are back in this. Defense by Jokic, anticipating the cut. DeMar DeRozan, enjoying his first season in San Antonio these days, gets the bounce there, an important bucket. Serbia, you see they're very patient with their set plays. Look at that pullback three. Oh, Ted Husic. Feeling it now. He had 18 points in this one and a game-high six assists, 4 for 7 from three-point land. Jokic takes a much-needed breather, but he'll be back because he's still to be heard from as Serbia continues their late push. And now, Radulica has Boogie Cousins dancing. Radulica, what a game for him in limited minutes. 18 points, only played 15 minutes, and you'll see why down here, because as they go to work, Cousins and Radulica leaning on each other. Deep three, Paul George around and out. Offensive rebound to Boogie Cousins, and he has the last dance in this matchup. Offensive rebound, Radulica fouls out. And this would be devastating to Serbia's comeback chances. 6 of 8 from the floor, 6 free throws, 18 points in just 15 minutes. More importantly, able to bang around with the USA's big guys, and that is an unfortunate out-of-bounds defense as Durant takes advantage and hammers down two more. He had 12. You see the numbers right there for Radulica. 6-point game, 5.5 to go. You see the U.S. far more aggressive getting to the line. Durant, not there. Big scramble. Possession still to the red, white, and blue. Not such an easy time on the inbounds now. Durant all the way in. Cousins trying to take advantage of Jokic. Off the scramble down low. Look at Paul George. Serbia thought he went up and down, but he didn't. And the lead back up to 8. Look at Markovic go to work. The drive all the way around. Cousins goaltending. It goes in anyway. Markovic had 12. Only 4 Serbians would be in double figures in this one. The U.S. had 6. Look at Kyrie Irving. One of the 6 in double figures for the U.S. He had 15 points, 5 assists. Under 5 to go. Serbia still in it, but they're going to need some big shots. And now, Markovic off the big drive. Good kick in the corner, wide open look, and here they come. It's a 5-point game. Of course, the U.S., they hit seven threes in this one. There's one right there. Paul George, so smooth off the screen. Another opportunity for the U.S. to push the lead up to double digits. Kyrie Irving setting them up. No hurry now. The clock is the friend of the USA. Irving letting fly. It's not there. Rebound to George. Durant. Deflected. Turnover. And now Serbia looking to exploit in the open floor. Still running their sets. Almost a lost handle. Watch this. Three. Coming up here. That's Nikola Jokic. Could have been a four-point play. He'll take it. A game-high 25 for him in this one, to go with six rebounds. 11 for 15 from the floor. Maybe would have been the MVP if they gave out those kinds of things in this game. And then off the penetration, there is that man, Jokic again, shoving Durant aside and laying it in. And here we go. It's back to five. Carmelo Anthony, such a different player than he was in Athens in his first Olympic experience. It did not go well for the U.S., the much publicized bronze medal, but he helped them earn gold in Beijing and London on his way to becoming the only three-time Olympic gold medalist in basketball. Big shot there and the foul. Lead back up to seven, 2 minutes to go. Great ball movement. And there's Jokic down low again. Earns the foul and the bucket. 3-point play, Serbia back within three again. Kyrie Irving has been known to isolate whenever he wants. You see now, letting the clock down, go down. USA still up three. He's gonna make a move. He's in, but not now. Swatage, and here comes Serbia. What an opportunity. And they go to Nikola Jokic on a matchup with Draymond Green. It's a big time in this game. Opportunity to cut the lead to one and misses badly. Solid defense from Green. Certainly knows how to defend in big time situations. Here we go, U.S. See the shot clock above the basket to your right. 10 seconds now. Opportunity for the U.S. to stretch the lead, turn it into a two possession game. Paul George a little short, knocked around. Shot clock winding down. Durant had to force it up, and here comes Serbia. What an opportunity. And Georgievich, the head coach, off to the knock out of bounds, says, give me a timeout. I want to talk this over. My goodness, 5.2 seconds to go. Serbia needs a three to force overtime. DeAndre Jordan, one time, one stop. So here it is. What an opportunity for Serbia. Fans here in the Carioca Arena treated to a spectacular game, much different than it looked early on. Due to the stick-to-itiveness and toughness of the team in red, they just kept after it. USA did not play poorly. Only committed 12 turnovers in the game. Coach K, remember, the U.S. just has to defend the three-point line. They're willing to give up a two. So here it is. What a chance for the Serbians. Do they go to Jokic? They have options for three-point shots. Off the loose ball right here. Paul George almost creates the turnover. Mateja Dosic finds Bogdanović. Remember, he had a big three in the third quarter. Not there. trying to force overtime, but on Bogdan's 24th birthday, there is no party. Team USA holds on barely. Serbia was 1-3 at that point, but they won three straight to make it all the way to the gold medal game. Australia showed the U.S. was vulnerable. Serbia's toughness kept them in this one and almost pulled the upset. Talented France was next for the USA, but as they celebrated a 21st straight win in Olympic play, Team USA continued to ride on that golden brick road. The last team to beat them, Manu Ginobili, in Argentina in the Athens 2004 semifinals. Remember that? Certainly, USA basketball does. An amazing group of men that made Argentina so proud. The Golden Generation celebrates this special group and tells the story of Argentina's memorable upset of the USA in Athens, and there it is. You don't need special screening tickets. Golden Generation is on right now at Olympic Channel, another profound sports feature from Five Rings Film. Hope you enjoyed this last Throwback Thursday, this latest one. More coming, reliving some of the greatest Olympic basketball games in USA history.